Glucosamine and chondroitin are popular supplements used for osteoarthritis. According to one estimate from the National Institutes of Health, 6.5 million adults, or 2.6% of the population, have used one or both of these products at some time. This is because some studies showed us that taking both of these together could slow the breakdown of cartilage in the joints, which may reduce pain and swelling, making it great for osteoarthritis. In this video, we look at what glucosamine and chondroitin are, how they work, why there is a conflicting data on this, and whether or not it is worth taking. So stay with me till the end. Also, real quick guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Glucosamine and chondroitin are constituents of cartilage, which you can find in your joints. Glucosamine is a building block for molecules called glycosaminoglycans that are part of the structure of cartilage. And we have the three commonly available forms of glucosamine, like glucosamine hydrochloride and acetylglucosamine. Only glucosamine sulfate is the one that's been the most researched, as it is believed to be the type that can thicken the synovial fluid in between the joints. Chondroitin, on the other hand, is a component of cartilage that plays a role in its resistance to compression, and it's usually found attached to proteins as part of a proteoglycan. It helps keep cartilage healthy by absorbing fluid and retaining water into the connective tissue, and may also block enzymes that break down cartilage too, which is key. So you got glucosamine building the cartilage and chondroitin protecting the cartilage. But what exactly is cartilage? Cartilage is the main type of connective tissue in your body. Its biggest role is to protect and cushion the ends of your bones, which is why it's found within your joints. But in people with osteoarthritis, this cartilage is wearing down. Your bones are starting to rub against each other and there is no cushion between them. Over time, this can lead to pain and affect your joint mobility, which we often see in the knees, hips, and hands and spine, which can be very uncomfortable. So naturally, it would make sense to start taking the building blocks of cartilage to support the joints in the form of a supplement. You see, there's been a substantial amount of research on the use of glucosamine and chondroitin separately or together for pain and joint function in people with osteoarthritis, but studies have had inconsistent results and expert evaluations of the evidence have reached conflicting conclusions on both sides. And I think it's important to preface this. But here's the thing. In many European countries, these supplements are already prescribed for osteoarthritis. In the US, the recommendations aren't quite there yet and are more moderate, which is why it's only classified as a supplement. This had largely to do with the findings from the GAIT trial from 2006 that took more than 1,500 people, compared the combination of glucosamine hydrochloride and chondroitin, both supplements individually, celecoxib or Celebrex, and a placebo, and found that the combination of glucosamine and chondroitin sulfate didn't offer significant relief to participants in general. But here's the thing, it did help a small subgroup of those with moderate to severe knee pain. And after the GAIT trial, a few more large studies came out. For example, the 2015 study called MOVES, which came out that followed 600 people across France, Germany, Poland, and Spain, and showed us the results of this latest study indicate that the combination of chondroitin plus glucosamine has efficacy comparable to that of celecoxib in relieving symptoms in patients with osteoarthritis of the knee with severe pain. And how it may even be a solution for those who have trouble with celecoxib and can't tolerate it. So that's awesome. I also wanted to point out this randomized double-blind placebo-controlled crossover study over 28 days in 18 people that found that serum CRP concentrations were 23% lower after glucosamine and chondroitin compared to placebo, which meant that glucosamine and chondroitin supplementation may lower systemic inflammation, which is another area of research that's fascinating. But what is the best form to take? Mayo Clinic researchers agree that glucosamine sulfate, not hydrochloride, with or without chondroitin sulfate, can be used for knee osteoarthritis. And which one to go with? I would always choose a supplement from a reputable manufacturer that follows good manufacturing practices. Look for products that undergo third-party testing for quality and purity, Thorne has an amazing glucosamine and chondroitin supplement that I linked a link for you down below. And they are both the sulfate forms of glucosamine and chondroitin, which are the most researched forms. There you can check out my entire catalog of supplements and shop my top three favorite ones. The starting dose for most glucosamine and chondroitin supplements is typically 1500 milligrams of glucosamine and 1200 milligrams of chondroitin daily. If you start feeling better after 1 or 2 months, you could reduce your dose to 1,000 milligrams of glucosamine and 800 milligrams of chondroitin per day. Also, guys, be patient when you take this supplement. It can take weeks for the effects to fully be brought on. This depends person to person, of course, and the severity of the osteoarthritis. And in terms of safety, they're safe for most people as long as they're used according to the directions on the supplement label. And you do want to check with your care team if you are taking warfarin, as it can interact with it. If you have a shellfish allergy, and same if you're a diabetic, check with them first, because this supplement may affect blood sugar levels too. But I'm more curious actually to hear from you guys. What are your thoughts on glucosamine and chondroitin? I'd love to hear them down below. In the meantime, subscribe if you found this video useful, and I'll see you on the next one.